Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.2, Problem 9. This is Section 7.2, Problem Number 9. It says look up the value for z in the chart, draw the graph, and shade in the appropriate region. So the number to look up is 1.94. So there's a four-step process to look up any number in the chart. Step one is write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. This one already has two places after the decimal, so step one is all set. Step two, split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. The rightmost digit is a 4. So I split the number into 1.9 and then 4. So I took the rightmost digit and I pulled it off. This splits the number into two parts, and that's step two. Step three, put a .0 in front of the rightmost digit that we pulled off. So the 4 gets written as a .04. And that brings us to step four. So in step four, the digit from the left, the 1.9, will tell you what row of the chart to look in. And the digit from the right with the .0 in front tells you what column of the chart to look in, and you'll see where they intersect. Make sure you're on the correct page of the chart. There's a positive page and a negative page. 1.94 is positive, so of course you want to be on the positive page of the chart. We'll go to the 1.9 row, the positive page of the chart, and the 0.4 column, and they intersect at 0.9738. So that is the answer, but we really need to understand what that answer means. So if you draw the bell curve, and then we'll label the bottom. Right in the center, we'll put a 0, positive 3 on the right, and a negative 3 on the left. And these numbers represent how many standard deviations you are away from the average value. 0 in the middle means 0 standard deviations away from average. So the average is the middle. It makes sense that 0 in the middle, 0 standard deviations away from the average. 3 on the right, 3 standard deviations larger than the average value. Negative 3 on the left, 3 standard deviations smaller than the average value. And then by eye on the positive side, you can split off positive 1, positive 2, positive 3. On the negative side, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. So now the 1.94, it would be a number along the bottom. So 2 right here, 1.94 would be almost out to the 2. So I'll put a vertical line at what I feel 1.94 would be. And the number from the chart, 9738, is the probability of being less than that number on our graph to the left of that number. So that's the area that I'll shade in. And I'll label it with 0.9738. So it's a little better than a 97% probability of being in the shaded region of my graph.